Our friend Jane Kaczmarek is here, has done such good work in front of the camera for so many things and such great work on the stage. And we're going to talk about that. And Jane, I told you about this before. In light of what happened in Pittsburgh, I posted a picture online this weekend. My mother was born in Germany, and this is carefree and happy in Coburg, Germany, with a Nazi flag in the background before she was aware of any of this or her family was aware. She participated and was saved by the Kindertransport. And that's what the play you're involved with is about. Mm-hmm. So I'm really glad you're here.
Thank you. All these years, yes. I'm happy to be joining you on this.
For those who don't know what Kindertransport means, what does it mean?
Kindertransport, after Kristallnacht happened in November of 1938, humane organizations in England, Canada, started realizing this is not going to stop. This is getting even worse than we ever thought. Let's get some of the kids out. And they organized for 10,000 Jewish children to be rescued before World War II happened, and they weren't able to get out. So children from Germany, Poland, Hungary, all parents who were lucky enough to get a place on these trains, gave their children, often through the windows of the train, infants. And they were whisked away to homes, volunteers, families in England. That's the story of what this is about. And obviously, most of the children never saw their parents again. These children also, this story about this little girl, Ava, is she goes to England, and she's going door to door trying to find work for her mother and father so that they can get a visa, so they can get out. But of course, in September of 1939, Poland's invaded, the war begins, and nobody can get out of Germany.
My mother was on a Kindertransport train to London, and which is the rare circumstance, was actually reunited with her entire family in America.
I just got goosebumps.
But lived separate.
The entire
from
family?
Five people all told, and yeah. It was separate. Lived effectively
God bless
alone.
Her.
But in any event,
when did she reunite with her family?
About 2 years after being on the train. So she spent two years in
yes.
London. In the context of all the, like a miraculous story, effectively my
this story is a little girl who leaves in January of 1939, before the war has started, meets them in a family, and her mother, she has letters for a while, and then the mother and father disappear and are assumed gone. And then there is a story at the end after she's about 1946, so she goes from being 9 to being 16 years old. And what happens when some things change in her life.
You have performed this play before. We're going to give you ticket information, how you can see Jane performing it again. It's a benefit for the Los Angeles Museum of the Holocaust. I mean, as you tell the story so effectively, do you feel it as you perform it, as you read it?
Yes, I first did this play in New York in 1994. And then we did it out here in Los Angeles at the Tiffany Theater in 1996. And then I did it again for LA Theater Works, which is a radio drama. And Perla Carney, who has been the producer all along, asked me to join the reading that's going to be at the Wallis on the 11th of November, honoring the 80th anniversary of the Kindertransport. It's very, one of the things I'm not Jewish, and playing the mother who gives her child away, I always found that before I would go on, I would always take a moment and ask for the spirit of someone, a mother who had perished in the Holocaust, to just guide me to be truthful, on stage. With what is happening with this survivor, and it's been a very profound experience. I used to do research when I first did this play, research in the New York Public Library, and pore over volumes of the atrocities. And I would come up, and it would be dark, and I would look at people on the street and think, why isn't everyone talking about this constantly? What happened to Jews in Europe, and obviously what is happening to Jews in Philadelphia, in Pittsburgh.
There's the phrase you hear about, obviously, in association with all, is never forget. Which is a theme of the Los Angeles Museum of the Holocaust. Let me show you the ticket information for your opportunity to see Jane and the performance. It's Kindertransport, the Wallis Theater for the Performing Arts in Beverly Hills, which is such a fantastic venue.
I have to kick in there.
Sure.
Also, Kate Burton is in it. Kate Burton was my roommate at Yale Drama School, and
oh my gosh,
have made a tremendous friendship. And through a series of stagecraft, she's playing my daughter.
Hmm. Oh, wow.
Grown up.
Okay. Wow.
We played a lot of things together, and our daughters are very good. Our real-life daughters, Charlotte and Frances, are very good friends, but I'm looking forward to being up.
Throw the full screen up one more time, and we'll tell you again. The event is taking place on November the 11th, and the website is ktla.com and thewallis.org, Kindertransport. All right, a smooch for Jane.
Oh, I love you.
I love you. Thank you. All right.
Thank you, Jane.
Thanks, you guys.
Thank you.